I've been talking to Bruce Lee mainly about the Chinese martial arts, which include things like Chinese boxing, karate, and judo, which is what he taught when he was in Hollywood after he left the University of Washington, where he studied, of all things, philosophy, if you can believe that. He did, but that perhaps you understand why the two go together from the first half of this program. And you can perhaps understand how he got into films. He knew a lot of actors, but I'm told that you got the job on The Green Hornet, where you played Cato the chauffeur, mainly because you're the only Chinese-looking guy who could pronounce the name of the leading character, Britt Reed.
I made that as a joke, of course. And it's a heck of a name, man. Yeah. I mean, every time I said it at that time, I was super conscious. I mean, really, now, that's another interesting thing, huh? Let's say if you learn to speak Chinese.
Yeah.
And it's very, I mean, it's not difficult to learn and speak the word. The hard thing, the difficult thing, it's behind what is the meaning, what brought on the expression and feelings behind those words. Like when I first arrived in the United States and I look at a Caucasian and I really would not know whether he was putting me on,
yeah,
or is he really angry, because we have different way of reacting to it. See, those are the difficult things, you see.
It's almost as if you came upon a strange race where a smile didn't mean what it does to us. Yeah. In fact, a smile doesn't always mean the same, does it?
Of course not.
Yeah, I just thought of that. Tell me about the big break when you played in Long Street. I must tell the audience that Bruce Lee had a bit part or a supporting role in the Long Street series, and this had an enormous effect on the audience. What was it?
Well, you see, the title of that particular episode of Long Street is called The Way of the Intercepting Fist. Now, I think the successful ingredient in it was because I was being Bruce Lee.
Yourself.
Myself, right. And did that part, just express myself, like I say, honestly express myself at that time. And because of that, I brought, you know, favorable mentioning in, like, New York Times, which says, like, the Chinaman, who incidentally came off quite convincingly enough to earn himself a television series, and so on and so on and so forth.
Can you remember the lines by Sterling Siliphant, the key lines?
He's one of my students, you know that?
Was he too?
Yes.
You've had everybody as your student. But you read, there were some lines that expressed your philosophy. I don't know if you remember them or not.
I remember that.
Let's hear.
This is what it is, okay?
You're talking to Long Street, played by James Francesca.
I said, empty your mind. Be formless, shapeless, like water. Now, you put water into a cup, it becomes the cup. You put water into a bottle, it becomes the bottle. You put it in a teapot, it becomes the teapot. Now, water can flow, or it can crash. Be water, my friend. Like that, you see?
Yeah, I see. I get the idea.
Uh-huh.
I get the power behind it. So, now, two things have happened. First, there's a pretty good chance that you'll get a TV series in the States called The Warriors, in which you use, what, the martial arts in a Western setting?
That was the original idea. Now,
yeah.
Paramount, you know, I did Long Street for Paramount, and Paramount wants me to be in a television series. On the other hand, Warner Brother wants me to be in another one, but both of them, I think, they want me to be in a modernized type of a thing. And they think that Western idea is out.
You want to do the Western, eh?
I want, because you see, I mean, how else can you justify all these punching and kicking and violence except in that period of the West? I mean, nowadays, I mean, you don't go around on the street kicking people or punching people. Because if you do, that's it. I don't care how good you are, you know.
But this is true also of the Chinese dramas, which are mainly costume dramas. They're all full of blood and gore over here.
You mean here?
Yeah.
Well, unfortunately, you see, I hope that the picture I am in would either explain why the violence was done, whether right or wrong or whatnot, but unfortunately, pictures, most of them here, are done mainly just for the sake of violence. You know what I mean? Like, you know, fighting for 30 minutes, get stabbed 50 times.
Well, I'm fascinated. Let me give you your microphone back. I'm fascinated that you came back
I am a martial artist.
You came back to Hong Kong on the verge of success in Hollywood and full of it, and suddenly, on the strength of one picture, you become a superstar. Everybody knows you. You have to change your phone number. You get mobbed in the streets. Now, what are you going to do? Are you going to be able to live in both worlds? Are you going to be a superstar here, or one in the States, or both?
Well, let me say this. First of all, the word superstar really turned me off, and I'll tell you why. Because the word star, man, is an illusion. It's something what the public calls you. You should look upon oneself as an actor, man. I mean, you would be very pleased if somebody say, hey, man, you are a super actor. It is much better than, you know, superstar.
Yeah, therefore, you've got to admit that you are a superstar. You're not going to, if you're going to give me the truth.
I am now. I'm honestly saying this, okay? Yes, I have been very successful,
yeah.
Okay? But I think the word star is, I do not look upon myself as a star. I really don't. I mean, believe me, man, when I say it. I mean, I'm not saying it because
what are you going to do? Let's get back to the question.
Okay.
are you going to stay in Hong Kong and be famous? Are you going to go to the United States and be famous? Or are you going to try and eat your cake and have it too?
I am going to do both because, you see, I have already made up my mind that in the United States, I think something about the Oriental, the true Oriental should be shown.
Hollywood sure as heck hasn't.
You better believe it, man. I mean, it's always that pigtail and bouncing around, chop chop, you know, with the eyes slant and all that. And I think that's very, very out of
Is it true that you were, the first job you had was being cast as Charlie Chan's number one
son? Yeah, number one son, yeah.
they never made a movie.
No. They were going to make it into like a new Chinese James Bond type of a thing. Now that, you know, the old man Chan is dead, Charlie is dead, and his son is carrying on.
But they didn't do that.
No. Batman came along, you see, because then everything was started to be going into that, you know, that kind of
which you were in. But
by the way, I did a really terrible job in that, I have to say.
Really? You didn't like yourself? No, I didn't see it.